ब्रिज कोर्स स्टैंडर्ड 10th साइंस। In our last session, we studied excretion in human being as well as in plants. Today's our topic is coordination. Have you ever seen group dancing on the stage or in the movies? All group is dancing together. If everyone is dancing in a specific rhythm, we can say that it is coordination is good. Their coordination is good. But if somebody is dancing with hand here and somebody is dancing with hand there, and if there is some mismatch, you say that coordination was mismatched, right? Similar to that, if in our human body there are various organs, various systems are there in our body. There is circulatory system, there is nervous system, there is respiratory system, so on. And in all this system, if there is perfect coordination, our human body sustain long life. But if this coordination mismatch, let me tell you one thing, all the systems of our body, which are they? Circulatory system, respiratory system, excretory system, reproductive system, nervous system, there are so many systems. And in all this system, if there is no coordination, let me tell you one thing, they are interlinked. How they are interlinked? If your respiration is disturbed, your circulation will be disturbed. If your circulation is disturbed, your digestion will be disturbed. If your digestion is disturbed, your excretion system will be disturbed. And if all these systems are disturbed, your nervous system will be collapsed. And the person may have death in such situation. So our all our system should be working in rhythmic manner, in proper coordination. So let us see coordination in plants first. Tropic movement. What do you mean by tropic movement? It is the movement or growth shown by the plant in specific direction, that is towards the stimuli. And if this growth is towards the stimuli, we can say the plant is moving. Can you say the plant is moving or not? Yes, we know plants don't move, but they show specific movements. What movements? Let us see. Look at this plant again. You might be thinking why this bottle is coming back here, but I believe that if you will see, you will understand it more better. Can you see the roots? Here are the roots which are white in color. Right? These roots are growing in downward direction. Just see our last video. These roots were not so much grown, but within a week there is a drastic change in their growth. And in which direction they are growing? They are growing downwards. Right? So can I say the response, the growth of root is stimulus towards the gravity? So it is gravotropic movement, towards the gravity. This movement is towards gravity in the downward direction. Whereas look at the stems. This is the new shoot which is coming out. Can you see this? It is growing in upward direction. Why it is growing in upward direction? It is growing in upward direction because the movement of plant is always, or the growth of the plant is always towards light. And if it is towards light, can I say it is phototropic movement? Photo means light. From which light? Sunlight. So the growth of the plant is towards upward direction, and upward we can see sun. So that is towards the sun, and sun is giving us light. That's why it is phototropic movement. The shoot system of any plant respond to the light stimulus. That is growth towards the source of light. The movement shown by plant towards the source of light is called as phototropic movement. Here you can easily see, I'm showing it with the help of arrow. Just look here carefully. This is the arrow which is showing the tilted form of this stem. It is tiltedly growing towards the window. It is clearly seen. We have placed a pot of hibiscus plant in a room in which all doors are closed but windows are open, so that the growth is shown towards the light. And that is, it is growing towards the light. Where is light coming from? From window. That's why these shoots are growing towards the light, towards window. Watch it carefully. There are certain hormones which are responsible for this growth. Hormones like auxin, which produce the apical part of the shoot, help in enlargement of the cell. Whereas hormones like gibberellin is responsible for elongation of stems. Whereas hormones like abscisic acid is effective in prevention or stopping the growth of plant leaf and wilting of the leaves. Look at this diagram. This diagram is of flower, internal part of flower. In this part, while pollination, pollen grains settle on stigma. As soon as they settle on stigma, in favorable condition, they form a tube-like structure inside. Can you see this yellow portion? This yellow portion is nothing else but it is pollen tube. This pollen tube is formed, and the movement of this pollen tube is towards the ovule, towards the ovary. So, if it is towards the ovary, we can say this movement is chemotropic. Towards the ovary, it is chemotropic. We have already studied that the movement of the root is towards downward direction, that is towards gravity. So this is also called as gravitropic movement, as well as now I have planted this plant in water, so there is no surge of water. But if I will plant the same plant into the soil, these roots will not will have to search water for their growth, and the movement which is in the search of water is also called as hydrotropic movement, towards the water. जमिनीमध्ये खोलवर पाणी असतं आणि त्या पाण्याच्या दिशेने ही मुवमेंट होत असते. दॅट्स वाय इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज ग्रॅव्होट्रॉपिक मुवमेंट, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज हायड्रोट्रॉपिक मुवमेंट. चिल्ड्रन, हॅव यू एव्हर सीन मिमोसा प्लांट? मिमोसा, डाऊट वाटतोय थोडा? लाजाळूचं झाड. सो दिस मिमोसा इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज टच मी नॉट प्लांट. अँड in this plant, if you touch the leaf, there is some movement into the leaf and all leaf get shrink, they get close. After few seconds they again open, and afterwards again if you touch it, again it close. This is the movement shown by the plant, but it is growth independent. This after opening and closing, there is no growth shown in the plant. So priorly we have seen all the movements. Which movement we have seen already? Gravotropic movement, hydrotropic movement, phototropic movement. All these movements show growth. Tyanchyamadhye growth dakhvatat. So these movements are growth dependent, whereas now which we are going to study, these movement are growth independent. They are not dependent for growth, these movements, okay, in plants. First is mimosa plant. I will show you the video, just see here. If video is present, I will definitely show it to you. This is mimosa plant. Look how sensitive the leaves are. They are compound leaves. If you touch it, they directly show the movement. They get together, get closer to each other, and they are showing movement. But this movement is not growth dependent. It is growth independent movement. Next time, whenever you see this plant, don't just pass away. Sit near this plant and try to pass some time with it. Definitely you will feel relaxed. This is my favorite time pass. Whenever you are in school, you can see this plant. As soon as you will come to school, just remind me you want to see mimosa plant. I will definitely get this pot in your class. Very nice movement is shown by these leaves. Look at carefully. After mimosa plant, the next one is Venus flytrap. Venus flytrap is the plant which has flowers like this, okay? They are leaf shaped and inside they are red in color and they are like this. The red color which is present inside is so fresh red color that insect get attracted towards the red color. And as soon as insect get attracted, the Venus flytrap get closed. And after closing it, it start digesting that insect which is present into the flower. So this plant is also called as carnivore plant. This movement of opening and closing is not growth dependent, right? Third movement, which is shown by lotus. Have you seen lotus? Kamal. So, during daytime, if you observe lotus, it opens slowly, right? And during nighttime, it closes. This movement of opening and closing of the petals of lotus is growth independent. Yancha ugadnyani ani bandh honyani त्या झाडाचं कुठलंही डेव्हलपमेंट होणार नाही. दॅट प्लांट डज नॉट शो एनी डेव्हलपमेंट ऑफ ग्रोथ, राईट. लोटस, ट्युबर रोजचं जर तुम्ही पाहिलं तर इट इज वाईस वर्सा. ड्युरिंग नाईट टाइम ट्युबर रोज ओपन अँड ड्युरिंग डे टाइम इट क्लोज, राईट. सो दिस मुवमेंट आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज ग्रोथ इंडिपेंडेंट मुवमेंट. देर इज लास्ट वन, दॅट इज बाल्सम. बाल्समचं फूल जर तुम्ही पाहिलं असेल तर इट बस्ट ओपन. जेव्हा ते पूर्णपणे वेन इट कम्प्लिटली राइपन्स, इट बस्ट ओपन ड्युरिंग नाईट टाइम. वाय इट बस्ट ओपन? बिकॉज इन ऑर्डर टू स्प्रेड द सीड्स. ते ओपन होतं पण ते इतक्या फास्ट आणि फुल स्पीडने ओपन होतं की त्याच्या आतमध्ये जे काही सीड्स आहेत ते लांब फेकले जातात. अँड इट बस्ट ओपन टू स्प्रेड द सीड्स. अँड दोज सीड्स इफ इन नॅचरल कंडिशन, favorable condition, if they get buried into the soil, new balsam plant is grown. This was all about plants. Identify the movements in the following figure. Just look at these figures and try to identify which movement they are showing. Question 2. What movement does mimosa plant show? Write whether it is which type of movement, whether it is growth dependent or growth independent movement.